Hi everyone, a very good morning. Welcome to the next session on HTML. I think this will be the last session regarding all the HTML concepts. This may be the last session. From the next session onwards, we will start CSS. We will start cascading style sheets. So in today's session, we are going to discuss about the topic called as forms. Forms in HTML, and in the previous class we have seen the things regarding frames concept. So by using frames we can divide the entire screen into multiple number of parts, where each and every part can have a separate HTML document. That is what we have covered in the last session, and in today's sessions, we are going to see about the forms. And myself, I am V. Dinesh Babu from the Department of CSE of Chebrol Engineering College. So, why we use these forms? In the sense, these forms are used to create some graphical user interface things through which we can. Right, so HTML forms, they are used to, the user input is most often sent to server for processing. For example, when you are working with when you are trying to put an application for an examination, you need to fill some data through online. In such cases, they will ask for your name, maybe your date of birth, maybe your hall ticket number, etc. So in order to enter all those data, there will be some graphical user interface components over the screen through which we enter some data, and the data will be obviously sent to the server for processing. So here in today's class also, we are going to create some user input. We are going to create some things like the things which collect some user input. So those things are created by using the concept of forms in HTML. So forms are used to create some graphical user interface things through which we can collect some information from the user. So let us see the next point. A form is defined by using a tag called as form, right? So HTML, the main feature of HTML is each and every tag name will be similar to the purpose of that particular tag. For example, if we are working with images, means we have to use the tag called as img. If we are working with the tables, means we have to use the tag called as tables. And similarly, if we want to create a form, input form, then we have to use a tag called as form tag. Next one. So it is the syntax of form tag. So there are several attributes for this form tag. Action, that is the first attribute, and the method is the second attribute. Encryption type is the third attribute, and we have some elements under this form, and then we use the closing tag of the form. So here for action, we have to supply one URL, right? What is the site name we have to provide to the action. And for the method, we can use either post or get. Post will send the information and get will receive the information. And encryption type is encoding. We can pass encoding to the encryption type. So I don't want to discuss all these things. I just in this class, we will see about how to create a different elements in a form by using HTML, right? So next one. So let us see the different elements. So in today's class and up to previous sessions, I completed the theory part regarding any concept, and then I worked with the program. But in today's class, I will explain each and every point, and parallelly I will work with the program so that it will be easy to understand for each and every person, right? So I will explain one tag, and I will show the tag parallelly in a program so that it will be very easy. So let us start. The first tag in the forms what we are going to see is called as form tag, right? This form tag is used to define some graphical user interface components by which we can take inputs from the user side, right? So if we want to take some inputs from the user side, we need to create some space for those inputs, and the type of spaces that were created are called as are defined in this form tag only. Okay, so let us write the form tag in our program. Okay, let us open the programs. Open edit place. Right, and this is the program what we have seen in the last session. I'm going to delete the code. Okay, so in the last session we have worked with the frame set tag. So in the last session there is no need of body tag while we are dealing with the frame set tag, but in this session we are going to work on with the forms. So we need body tag here, and within the body tag only we have to use the form tag, and within the form tag only we have to use multiple number of forms and multiple number of tags in order to create some inputs. So here in today we are working with the concept called as forms in HTML. That is why I have changed the title to forms in HTML. So within the body tag, use a tag called as a form, and then at the end we have to close this form tag, right? So that is the first tag what we have seen in the PowerPoint presentation. Form tag, it defines an HTML form to enter inputs from the user side. So if we want to have want to enter some inputs from the user side, we need to create some form. And then next one, let us look at the next tag. So the next tag is called as input tag. So if you use this particular tag, that is input tag, so they will create some text field on the web page, right? So now just save this code and observe the output. Here our program name is frames.html. So let us open the frames.html which was located in the documents. Frames.html, once again, and here it is. This is the program what we have just modified. Let's open the program, right? So once again, and this is the output of this code. The output of the code is also on the right side, and it is the code what we have written. So here our title name is forms in HTML. So we got the title for the web page as forms in HTML, and inside the body tag we have just used the form tag, and we have used nothing here. That's why the entire body of this web page is empty, right? So now let us add each and every tag what we see in the PPT, so that we will see the output of that particular tag parallel, right? So first tag, under the form tag we have a tag called as input tag. So it defines an input control. That means this particular input tag will create a text field on the web page. So let us use this input tag here, input, right? And close this input tag. No need to use any other text, right? Close the input tag once again. Close the input tag, right? So save this particular code, and then observe the output of that code by pressing on the refresh button. So if you observe here, a normal text field have been created so that we can enter any text or any numbers or any symbols here. So in order to create a text field on a web page by using the HTML, that is hypertext markup language, we have to use a tag called as input tag. So let us see what will happen. Right, I'm cleaning all this data. Let us see what will happen if we write something in between the form, the input opening tag and closing tag. For example, I am going to write some CSC between input opening tag and closing tag. I'm saving this code and I'm making a refresh on this one. So if we write something between the input tags, that thing will be represented after the, that means after that particular text field, right? So next one, let us see what will happen if we directly write something here. Let us see what will happen. Just save the code and refresh the code. So that thing was represented before the text field. So let us use full name, right? Full name here. The same thing can be written by using a tag called as label tag. So while we are working with HTML5, we write something here that will be directly displayed on the web page. No problem with that. So if you use label means, that thing will be represented as a text on the web page. So there is nothing to do with this label. It will just use it to display some information on the web page. So save the code, right? And refresh the web page. So we have one label called as full name, and we have some area which is reserved so that we can enter any of our name in this particular text field, right? So let us look at the next tag. So we have completed form, we have completed input, and we have completed label also. Here we can see the label tag. So it is used to, it defines a label for an input element. So if there is some input element, so what is to be entered in that input element is defined by using this label tag. And then the next tag is text area. So let us use this text area tag. If you are dealing
So if you want to enter a multi-line input control, we have to use a tag called as text area. And then we can close this tag. And before that, we can use address. Right? So let us see what happens if you use the following text area tag. Save the code, and then make a refresh so that we got something like we got a field in order to enter multiple number of lines.
So here we got some space in order to enter multiple lines of data. So that is the use of text area tag. Now I think these four tags are clear for everyone. Input, it is used to create a text field so that we can enter only one line of text. And text area, it is used to create an input field where we can give multiple lines of data. And then label, it is just to say what the input control is on the web page, right? Label, it is used to just display some text on the web page, right? And next one, let us move to the next slide here. It is the next slide. So these are the tags. Let us see each and every tag. Field set. So this field set will group some elements in the form, right? For example, till now, if you observe our web page, we have created one label, one text field, second label, and text area. We have created four things: two labels, and then one text field and one text area. So if we want to group all these four things, right? Use the tag called as field set tag. So that all these things which are represented so far will be under one category. That is, there will be some group. It will group all these things. So let us see how it will group all these things. Save the code and make a refresh here. So there is some horizontal line. In the above of horizontal line, all these things are represented. That means this field set tag is grouping all the things which are represented so far in this program, right? So now let us see what will happen if the same field set tag was used in between any two things. Let us delete the field set tag here and let us insert the particular field set tag here. So I am trying to group full name and I am trying to leave the input, that is the text field and the address and the text area. So let us see, let us save the code and make a refresh here. If you observe, the full name was grouped somewhere and the remaining was left alone, and the remaining things are left on the web page. So let us use this same field set tag after input. So full name and input will be in one line, address and text area will be in another line. So let us see, save the code and then make a refresh. So you can observe full name and the text field was in one group and the address and the text area was in another group. So this is how we can use the field set tag. So field set tag is used to group the related element in the form. And then there is one more tag called as legend tag. Legend. So this legend tag is used to have define some caption to the field set element. So here we have one field set, that is we have some division over the elements of the web page. So if there is nothing here, there is no name. So no name for this field set tag. If you want to give some caption for this field set tag, we can use the legend tag. So after using the field set tag, right, use the tag called as legend tag. It just gives some name to the field set tag. Now there is nothing more than that. Legend, hi, and close the legend tag, right? Just save the code and observe the output. There is something, some text called as hi is added after the field set tag. So let us see what will happen if you use the same legend tag, right? If you use the same legend tag in between this field set tag, let us see what will happen, right? Just save the code and then make a refresh here. So our field set is given one name called as hi. So this is how we can group some of the elements on the web page by using a tag called as field set tag, and we can provide some name for that field set tag. And in order to provide some name for that field set tag, we use a tag called as legend tag. Right. Coming to the next one. After legend tag, there is one more tag called as select. It defines a drop-down list. Drop-down list means there will be one arrow on the input control. If we may click on that arrow, some options will be displayed. Right. So the type of input control is called as drop-down list. So in order to create a drop-down list, we can use the select option. Right. And keep this one aside. I will explain it later. And then there is one more thing called as option. So it defines an option in a drop-down list. So just not only this select tag will define the entire drop list. Select tag is only used to define a drop-down list. That's it. So if we want to have some options inside the drop-down list, we need to use this option tag. So let us use these two things, select and option. And apart from these two things, there is one more tag called as opt group. This opt group is used to define group of related options in a drop-down list. So if there is something, n number of options in a drop-down list. So if we want to group some options, we can use this opt group option. So I will explain it later. So let us use this select tag and option tag in order to create a drop-down list over the web page. So I am using this select tag here, select, right? Select, And then I'm going to use some options. For example, option one, I'm closing this option tag, right? Yes, I want to copy, control C. Right, after the completion of all the options, you can close the select tag, right? So let us see what will happen. Let us remove these options. Let us remove these options and save the code. First observe the output, and then later we can add options. Save the code and make a refresh. So we got something here. There is one drop down arrow, but there is nothing displayed here. So it is just an empty drop down list. So for that empty drop down list, add some data by using a tag called as option tag. So I have created four options here, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. So let us save the code and make a refresh on the web page. So you can see here, initially before the changes which were made in the program, there is nothing in the drop-down list, but we have added four options, 1, 2, 3, 4. So now if you click on this one, you get all these four options, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So this is how we can create a drop-down list. This is how we can create a drop-down list on a web page by using HTML. So let us use this opt group tag here. What will happen, and let us see what will happen if you use this opt group. One second, GR. Opt group tag here. Let us close this opt group tag here. And let us see what will happen. Save the code, right? And make a refresh here. And if you open 1 and 2, belongs to one group. They are represented in the middle. That is, they are belongs to one group, and 3 and 4 belongs to another group. 3 and 4 are normal options. So if you want to make some options as a group, we can use this option called as opt group. That is why it was represented in the PPT. So if you want to create a drop down list, we need to use the select option. If you want to group some options in the drop-down list, we can use opt group. And if we want to have some options in the drop-down list, we need to use the tag called as option tag. And then coming to the next tag, button. So it is defines a clickable button. So we are trying to log in with the Gmail, we enter our mail, and then we enter our password, and then we click on the thing called as sign in. That sign in is called as button. So in order to create such type of buttons for a web page by using HTML, we have to use the tag called as button tag, right? There is one tag called as button tag. So let us create, and before going to the button tag, let us use which here. Let us create this button, right? Button, right? And just use the closing tag for this button and observe the output, and then later we can make some changes. So save the code and make a refresh here. We got something. You can observe here, we got something which was very minute, which was very little here. So if you want to have some name over the button, just view here, login. Give the name here so that login will be appeared on that particular button, so that the button size will be somewhat higher than the previous output. Save the code. Now make a refresh here. You can observe here. There is one button. We can make a click on that button, and the name on that button was login. Because here, between the button tags, we have used the name called as login. That is why the name is added on the particular button, right? So this is how we can create buttons or the web pages by using HTML. I think everything is clear until now. So just refer the things what we have studied so far. Form, it is used to create input forms. Input tag, it is used to create text field. Text area, it is used to create some multiple lines of text field or text area. Label, it is just used to add some caption or it is just used to display some text over the web page. And then field set, it is used to group some elements over the web page. Legend, it is used to give some caption for the field set, right? And then select, if you want to create a drop down list, we can use the select option. Opt group, if you want to group some of the options in that selection in the drop down list, we can use opt group. And if you want to have some options in this drop down list, we have to use this option tag. And if you want to create a clickable button on the web page, we have to use this button tag. This is these are the tags what we have done so far. Let us move to the next tags. So these are the one way of creating all these things. And there is one tag called as input tag, very, very important. And it was the most frequently used tags in the forms, input. So for the input tag, before going to see about the input tag, these are the attributes of input tag: type, name, value. This name is used for reference purpose. Type means for the type, we can provide any of the following below types. I will explain each and every type later. And then value means what is the value we want in that particular input graphical user interface component. That is, for example, if we have created a text field, what is the default value we want in the text field that should be represented here in the value, right? I will explain each and every type now. So let us see the first type. If we provide text to the type attribute, then it will create one line text input field. We have seen earlier, if you use an option called as input, if you use an option called as input, then it will create a single line text field. Similarly, if you provide text as an attribute to the type, sorry, text as a value to the type attribute, then it will create a single line text field. So let us see how it will work. So I'm going to use an input tag, right? Input. So here I am going to use some attributes. Type equal to, here I want to create some text, right? And then value equal to some full name. So I want some value full name on the text field. So after the completion of this, just close the input tag. So now save the code what you have written, and then make a refresh here. You can observe there is one more text field added. In the text field, there is already some text which is default added. The text is full name, because we have used full name for the value attribute. That is why this particular text field is created with this value, right? So that is the first type we can provide. So what happens if you use password? So let us check, let us copy the code and use each and every option, and let us see the output parallelly so that it will be very easy to understand. So now use the password and see what will happen here. Use the password. So the difference between a text field and password field is that if you use a text field, if we enter any type of text or a number or a symbol, that will be directly displayed on the field. But when we use a password field, in the sense, if you enter any number, symbol or a character, single dot will be displayed, and dots will be displayed in place of all those things. So let us verify each and everything. So save the code and then make a refresh here. So there is one more field. Two text fields are added. We cannot say there are two text fields. It is a text field and a password field. So for both the things, we have passed the value full name. So here the full name is displayed on the text field, but here instead of full name, some dots have been displayed in the field because it is a password field. So anything we enter here will be displayed as a dot, but it is a text field. Anything we enter here will be displayed as a text, right? So that is the difference. It is a text field, it is a password field. So if we want to create a text field, we have to pass type equal to text. If we want to create a password field, we have to pass type equal to password. So that password field will be created on the HTML, and similarly text field will be created on the HTML. And now let us move to the next tag, submit. So we have some tag called as button. That similar type of button can also be created by using submit. So let us use this submit now. Okay, just paste the thing, and here use submit. Here the value is full name for all the things, right? So let us see what will happen if you use input type equal to submit, and yes, make a refresh here. So there is one more button added, and the name of the button is full name. So because we have passed the value full name to the type submit button, right? And next one, reset. So the difference between the submit button and reset button is that if you use the submit button, it will transfer the entire data what you entered in the form to the server. And if you use the reset button, means it will clear the entire data in that particular form. So let us see the difference, right? Let us see the difference. Just save the code. Save the code. And just I am changing some names. Clear. And here I am creating two buttons. The first one is a submit button, and the second one is a reset button. On the first button, submit will be displayed, and the reset button, clear, will be displayed. So that is what we have made changes. So save the code. Now make a refresh here. So you can observe there are two buttons. First one is a submit button, and the second one is the clear button. And here, let us add some data here. Let us write my any name. Okay, let us write some name here and enter some address here, right? And then select any one option. I am going to select 3, and I am going to enter something here, and I am going to have some password. So let us see what will happen if you make a click on the submit button. So if you make a click on the submit button, everything is clear. But inside, what will happen inside the page means, if you write some background code, means the entire data was carried out to the server. Entire data will be carried out to the server. And if you use the clear button, if you use the clear button, means the entire data on the web page will get cleared, and nothing will be carried out to the server. So if you want your data to be carried out to the server, then we have to click on submit button. If you want the data to be clear, we have to use the clear button. That means, so in order to create a submit button, we have to pass submit to the type attribute. And in order to reset, create a reset button, we have to pass reset to the type attribute. And next one. So next one, radio. We all know radio buttons. Radio buttons means those buttons will be in the circular form, and we can select any one of the button among those buttons. For example, I will show. So let us see the description here. It defines a radio button which allows select only one option. For example, if I ask what is your gender, either you can select male or female. You are not supposed to select both of them. So for such type of questions, there is only one options, one answer should be given for each and every user. Such type of things can be created by using these radio buttons. And if I ask which year you are studying in BTech, you can say either first year or second year or third year or fourth year. At the same time, you cannot study any 2 years, right? So you can study only 1 year. So for such type of input things, we create these radio buttons. So let us see how to create a radio button. So in order to create a radio button in HTML, we have to pass type equal to radio. So let us check here. Type equal to input. I'm going to create a radio button called as type equal to radio, right? So here I'm going to represent some text called as first year. First year, right? So save the code and then make a refresh here. So there is one button added, so we can select that button, right? We can select that button, and then if you want to add multiple number of buttons, use the same I'm just copying and pasting each and everything, and now I'm trying to change the things, right? So now save this code and make a refresh here. So there are four options: first year, second year, third year, fourth year, and you can select first year. If you select second year, means one second. So here what is happening in the sense, each and every option is going to be selected. So in order to make the proper work of this radio buttons, just provide, we have studied about the name attribute before. So the name attribute is used here. So name equal to year of study, right? Name equal to year of study. So if you use this name for all the things, for all the radio buttons what you have created so far, use the name for all the radio buttons, right? Right now, save the code and make a refresh here. Now select one year and try to select another year. So two options cannot be selected at a time. You are allowed to select only one option. So this is possible when we use name attribute to the input type equal to radio. So that name should be same for each and every group of radio buttons. So if the name is different, means for example year of study, and then I am using some other name for the options third year and fourth year. For example, I am using some other name called as place. So these two belongs to one group. There is one and two. First year, second year belongs to one group. Third year and fourth year belongs to one group. That means we can select any one from this group and we can select any one from this group. So let us see. Save the code. Make a refresh here. So the four buttons are created. Now I selected first year. If I try to select the second year, means it cannot work. Only one option you can select. You can select either first year or you can select either second year. At the same time, you are allowed to select either third year or fourth year, because these two belongs to year of study and these two belongs to place. You can see here, these two belongs to year of study, first year and second year. These two belongs to name place. So you can select any one place. You can select any one year of study. So this is how we can create radio buttons on a web page using HTML. So next one, let us see an option called as checkbox. Checkbox defines, allows to select multiple options in a form, right? Let us use this checkbox. Let us use, just change the things. Instead of radio, use the option called as checkbox, right? So checkbox, I'm trying to create multiple number of checkboxes where the names of those checkboxes are Telugu, Hindi. Why I'm writing these languages in the sense, for example, if there is some question over the web page, the question is, select the languages do you know? So one user may know only Telugu, one user may know both Telugu and Hindi, one user may know both Telugu, Hindi and English. So we have to allow the user in order to select more than one option, right? For such type of input things, we have to create these check boxes. Just save the code and make a refresh here. So you can observe there are three things which are created with the name Telugu and Hindi and English. If I know Telugu, Hindi, English, I can tick all these three things. If I know Telugu and Hindi means I just tick those two things. So for the things where we can provide only one option, those things can be created by using radio buttons. For the things where we can provide a multiple number of answers, we can create these check boxes, right? And then button, we have already seen how to create a button, right? And then file. So while writing, while uploading something, we have to upload, there is some need of uploading files from your computer. So in order to create a selection of file from the web page, we can use this file. So let us see what will happen, and you can easily understand when we use this file option. You can easily understand when you see the output of this file option. Here I'm going to use type equal to file. Right, I'm going to use type equal to file. I'm saving the code and just observe the output. So there is something called as choose file. There is something called as choose file button, and the name associated with it was fourth year, because here we have used some fourth year. If you delete it, there will be nothing here. Save the code and make a refresh here. So there is nothing. There is only one option called as choose file. So what will happen if you make a click on this choose file, in the sense, it will allow the user to select any one file from the computer, from your local computer system. So let us see. I'm going to click on this choose file. So it is allowing us to select any one file from our computer, right? So you can select any one file from our computer and you can add that particular file to our web page. So this is how we can create a choose file button or the web page. So that is possible by passing file value as a file value to type attribute. Okay, and next one, image. So if somebody is feel very bored of having a normal text buttons, if you want some image on a button, graphical submit button, so then we can use this image. So let us see what will happen if you use this image. Right, what will happen if you use this image on one second, let's use the thing image here. Image, save the code, and now observe the output by making a refresh here. So there is one small image. The image was not inserted. We can insert any of the image of our own, right? So there is something called as a button through which we can make a click on this clickable button, but there is some image which is associated with this particular button, right? So this is how we can create a graphical image button by using a attribute called as image attribute. And radio, we have already seen regarding the radio. And let us move to the next slide. Color. So we can define an input field with a specific color. So in order to define an input field with a specific color, we can use type equal to color. So let us use this one. Let us use paste the thing and use the attribute color. Just save the code and observe the output. So there is one option called as color option, through which we can select any color from the web page, right? So that is, it defines an input field with a specific color, right? Next one, date. It defines an input field for selection of date. So if you want to allow the user to select the date, right? If you want to allow the user to select the date from the web page, you can use this option called as date, so that some field, input field will be created, and from that input field user can select the date, save the code and make a refresh here. There is something called as a date, month and year. So if a user click on this particular thing, so the user can select any date from here. He can select some year, or he or she can select some date or anything. So this particular input field will allow the user to select any date, right? So that is possible by using type called as date, right? Next one, date, time, local. So what happens if you use this date, time, local is it defines an input field for entering a date without time zone. So there is no need of time zone. Without time zone, he or she can enter some date. So let us see what will happen if you use date, time, hyphen, local. Paste the thing here, date, time, hyphen, local. Local, save the code, make a refresh here. So there is a there is one more input field which was created, right? Here we can select the date and we can have some time here, so without any time zone, right? Next one, email. So it defines some text field which will take email from the user. Copy the thing, one second. The thing and use it here in place of image, just use email and observe the output, save the code and observe the output, make a refresh here. So there is some field in which we can enter our email. So it is similar to the text field, right? And next one, month. It defines a control with month and year without time zone, right? So let us see what will happen if you use this month here. Save the code, observe the output here. So there is something which we can select only month and year. So here we cannot select any date, right? We can select only month and year, month and year, right? So if you want to have date, month and year, you can select an option called as date. If you want to have date along with the time, you can use the option called as date, time, local. If you only want to have month and year, you can use the option called as month, right? And next one, coming to the next slide. Next slide, number. It defines an input field to enter a number. So there may be some situations if you want to ask the user for a please give your phone number, then the user should enter only numbers. He or she should not be allowed to enter any text or symbols. He or she is allowed only to enter numbers. So in order to create a number field inside a web page by using HTML, we can use a number, right? Let us see what will happen if you use this type, right? Yes, paste here and type equal to number and save the code and make a refresh here. There is one field so which is not taking any text. I'm trying to type the text but it is not allowing us to take the text, but when I try to enter some numbers, it is going to take some numbers here. So this type of field can be created by passing the value number to the type attribute, right? And next one, URL. It defines a field for entering URL. It is similar to text field. And then week. So it defines a field to enter the date with week, year and without time zone. So let us see what will happen if you use, we have used a time, month, and now we are going to see about the week. save the code and make a refresh here. So there is some option where we can select, right, where we can select week and month and year, right? We can select only any 1 week, right? If you want to select the date, month and year, you have to pass date. If you want to select the date, month and year along with the time, you have to put date, time, local. And then if you want to have only month and year, we can pass month. And if you want to select any month, we can pass, sorry, if you want to select any week, we can pass week, right? And next one, moving to the next one, search. So this will create one input where we can, where that input field can be used to search in our web page. So let us use this search option. Input type equal to search, save the code, make a refresh here. There is one option here. So if you enter something here, like if you enter some text, means the text will be compared, the text will be compared with all the text which was represented on the web page. So this is called a search box, and this search box can be created by passing search value to the type attribute. And next one, tell means it is used to create a field to enter any telephone number, right? So it is similar to the number option. So in the number option also, you are supposed to enter only numbers. Similarly, you can use this tell option. So this tell option is used to take phone numbers, telephone numbers, right? Make a refresh here. There is one thing, right? There is one more field created, which is used to take some numbers. And at the same time, it is also allowing to enter some text also. But when we use the number field, means it will never allow text. I'm trying to type the text, but it is not considering. But when I'm trying to enter some number, means it is considering the numbers. And coming to the next one. So select tag. So select tag is used to create a drop-down list with multiple options, what we have seen already. And option tag also we have seen. And opt group tag also we have seen. And with this, I am going to close today's session. And if you have any queries regarding today's session, you can just text me or comment in the comment box. Hope you all get some enough knowledge in today's sessions. We have went a little bit faster when compared to the remaining sessions, because I'm trying to complete, it is already 10 classes have been over with only HTML. We have to start CSS, and that CSS will take almost 4 or 5 classes. So in order to complete the first unit, we need one more week. So that is why I went a little bit faster to complete HTML. Hope you all got some enough knowledge here. And please practice each and everything what I have explained in the class. And at the same time, search in the web, and there will be many more tags under the forms. So those forms can also be practiced by you, so that you will get some perfectness. So I will, and thank you very much one and all for listening to this video. And thanks a lot.